The world population is aging rapidly. Between 1952 and 2097, the share of people on our planet aged 65 plus is projected to increase by 333%. Why is this happening? In our view, there are three core drivers behind this significant trend. First is retiring baby boomers. Secondly is the falling fertility rate. And thirdly is the rising life expectancy that we see around the world. Our work is suggesting that whilst meaningful, some of these demographic trends are perhaps not as great in terms of impact on asset markets as some previous studies have suggested. Most studies that we have seen are still based on measuring people by calendar age. We feel it's much more significant now to address the amount of the life that people feel they have left. And with improving health, with extended life expectancy, we find that people's behavior is changing, both in terms of their supply to the labor force, but also their consumption patterns. And that would include the amount of time they're staying in academia and the amount of time they plan to work. And so it's extending the period of savings into risk assets. It's extending the time beyond which they start to reduce risk, and ultimately the time they leave the workforce and start to draw down on their savings. This is changing significantly the pattern from that which we saw 20 or 30 years ago, or longer than that. As a result of these changing trends, we see here in the US likely downward pressure on stock valuation, but upward pressure on inflation and on real bond yields. More globally, there are some differences with a more stable impact on inflation, but also downward pressure on stock valuations and on real yields. So in conclusion, we believe that the demographic changes that we've highlighted are meaningful, but not as important in terms of drivers of asset markets as some other studies have suggested. And indeed, that the business cycle still remains the key driver of asset prices in coming years.